Hello everyone. So I figured I'd go ahead and just record this. I was sitting here bored and I decided to make a really quick card. It's pretty quick and simple. I wanted to play with these Sue Wilson dies that I haven't really played with. So I busted them out. So this is going to be a shaped card. So for the base of my card, I used the largest die of the set to create my card base, and it is on the side. Now for this card base, I did use long paper, so I just folded it in half. So this is one solid piece, but you can do it with a hinge if you do not want, or if you don't want to use that large paper, or if you don't have any. So this space here I created with a hinge. Here's where you can see where I glued this other piece on top, but it's the exact same thing. Anyways, so I have my card base. This is cut out of 100-pound cardstock. So I use that. Now for this piece here, this filigree piece, I used this inner filigree piece, which does not cut, the border of it does not cut out. It is just the inlay. Oops. It is just the inlay that you see here. To get the outer piece, I use the second to largest die from the set. It is the exact same shape as this one, only smaller. I also cut out two of the little mats with the smaller inner frame. Now for my lavender piece, which I'm going to use as a backing for this filigree piece, we have this one. As you can see, there's little etchings on it, little lines. I used the Cordoba from the same collection, which is the Spanish collection. This one is, I'll mention it again, this one is the Seville. I used the Cordoba for the outer frame so I can mat it. The good thing about these is from the collection, she has all kinds of different designs, and they're all slightly different sizes, so you can use them to mat. You can interchange them from one die set to the other. So I had already started. Here's where you have one of them pieced together. You have the lavender background, the black filigree part, and the sentiment. This is going to be for the inside of my card. So I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing for the others. This is just a really simple card. When I had it in mind, I created this embellishment here, oh, almost a year ago, and it's just been sitting in my drawer. I haven't done anything with it, and I wanted to make a card with it, so I thought I'd make a really quick and simple card. This card doesn't really have much on it. That's going to be my focal piece. What makes the card look fancy is the die itself. So now I'm just getting some glue. I'm using Fabri-Tac, and I love the way this glue smells. It smells awesome. I typically use ATG, but since I wanted a little wiggle room in case I needed to move this, I wanted to go ahead and use a wet adhesive. So there's a mat there. Oh, and I just see that I forgot to take out two little pieces from it. Well, you can't really notice too much. Oop, and I shifted it a little bit when I was moving it. There we go. So there's panel number two. Gonna do the same thing with this one. Let's make sure I cut all the little pieces out. There we got one. So anyway, so yeah, I've had these dies, oh, I don't know, several months. I probably bought these well before Thanksgiving, and I just haven't used them. I've kind of been in this funk. It's like I have the mojo. I know what I want to craft. I know what to do. I just haven't felt like it. So I sit there and I think of all these ideas, and I'm like, yeah, I'm gonna do it. And then I don't. I'm just tired, I guess. A lot of been really busy at work, so it's kind of been driving me away from crafting, which is kind of the odd thing because I usually craft to de-stress from work, and I haven't been doing it, so I've been a bit cranky. Alrighty, so here's my matting. So here are my three pieces, and now this is all that is going to go on my card. Oh, let's glue this guy down. We can use ATG for this one. This is just a really small area for the person who is giving this card away to write a little message, sign their name. I mean, most people don't write really huge, so it's not like the area has to be extremely large. Just let's lay that bad boy down there. Alrighty, so I got my three panels. This panel without the lavender in the center is going to be for my front. So let's go ahead and do the inside first. I always like to do the inside of my cards first before I do the outside. That way, just in case I screw up, it's a little bit easier for me to fix. Let's use ATG. And you can probably hear my kids in the background as always. And I put a lot of adhesive on my stuff. Alrighty, so let's do this side. Let's see. That's good enough for me. Now let's do the sentiment side. So anyways, yeah, I'm trying to get back into card making. I haven't really been making very many cards. I tried to make some cards that were really similar to cards I've done in the past, just in different colors and possibly changing an element or two, just so I can get used to crafting again. But I haven't really done that. I mean, I laid them out together. I have everything cut. I have all the filigree pieces and stuff that I want to use on the card. I just need to adhere it all down. So there's the inside. As I said, very simple, and all it took was just a couple of die cuts. So let's do the front. But yeah, so I might show those cards when I finally glue them down. I mean, they're pretty similar to ones in the past, so it's not like it's going to be anything new. Just different colors and possibly different die cuts. But like the metal embellishments, the layout and stuff will be exactly the same. But it's okay. I mean, at least share something, right? Okay, so let's get this. That seems pretty good there. So there's the front. It there, and then I'll stamp it on the back with my handmade by stamp. So this is already put together. This comprises of, let's see, this is two different style filigrees laid on top of one another. Then we have a cabochon setting here, and then two butterflies layered on top, and it's underneath the, this is a Cherry Lynn, the Sophia's Heart mini doily that's underneath. So I'm going to put this in the center here. Now, I don't think I'm going to put anything that says happy birthday on the front. I will just leave this in the front here. Usually I put a little label in the front that says happy birthday, but we do have the happy birthday on the inside. I'll just glue this down, and if I change my mind, I can always add it. Yeah, that's probably all that I want there, because I could use a little label to get a happy birthday in right here. But yeah, no, I don't like it there. Possibly centered there. Nah. We can just leave it without any kind of sentiment in the front, I guess. Opening it. No, I want something in the front. Yeah, maybe we can move this off to the side. Alrighty, let me pause the video for just a second till I decide what I want to do, and then once I decide, I'll be right back. Alrighty, I'm back. So, let me close my door real quick because the kids are being a little bit too loud. So I did decide to go ahead and put a little sentiment. I took my Stampin' Up! Modern Label Punch and I used the Happy Birthday from... This is from, it's an Amy R. stamp set. This is the stamp set that I use. It's the Boutique Sentiments. This is perfect. Majority of these fit inside the Modern Label when you punch it out. Alrighty, so let's get some ATG on this bad boy. I'm not gonna pop it up. We'll keep this centered here. So let's tuck this guy. Yeah, we'll just leave it right there. I should have left it without anything, but of course I can't make up my mind. So I'm using Glossy Accents to adhere my metal embellishment down. And of course this is clogged. So let's open this back up. Alrighty. So I'm gonna use some of that on this piece. And since I have this cardstock middle here, I'm actually just gonna use ATG on that piece. It'll help keep it in place. Typically when I make my own metal embellishments like this, I always put cardstock, I always glue cardstock to the center to help it adhere. Because Glossy Accents takes a little bit while, a while to dry, so this helps it from shifting while the Glossy Accents is setting. Okay, actually let's just use the Fabri-Tac on it. Have it out, might as well use it. Oh, I totally love this way this glue smells. I'm weird, I know, a lot of people don't like it, but it smells so good to me. Mm. And I don't have my Fabri-Tac in the container that it came in. I put it into these, you get this in the, cake decorating section from, I got those at Walmart. It's just so much easier to squeeze the glue bottle. The Fabri-Tac bottle is so hard. Gets on my nerves. Alrighty. So here's the card. I will probably leave it this way. I mean, I could put bling on the end. Let's do that. Let's put some bling on this. I mean, it already has bling in the center. Let's see, amethyst, topaz, hematite. I'm actually looking through my tray here to get the same color because I use light amethyst on the butterfly. So let's go with, for the corners, let's do, we can do SS16. Yeah, let's do SS16. SS30 would be too big, and I don't have SS20 in that size. So get the katana out. And I usually don't have to bring out the mat. It just makes it a little bit easier than putting the stones directly on my craft mat. I just scoop a few out with my nail. Then let's see, let's put it, where shall we put it? Right in the corners. Right here is good enough for me. I'm probably putting too much Glossy Accents on this. Now for these glass rhinestones, I typically use Glossy Accents because I don't want them to fall off, but on when you're going from the bling directly to paper, you could definitely use like, what is the name of that glue? Gem Tack. So let's go ahead and put these down. And see, this is so easy. All you do is barely touch it. Am I even in frame? Barely. Barely tap the stone. And once it touches the glue, it releases it. You don't have to use another pokey tool or something to get it to come off the tip. All right. I guess that's enough bling. No. Let's add a little more. You know me. I like my bling. We'll put two small ones on either side of... on either side of the little one. So let's use, what size do we want to use on this? Let's use SS8. These are nice and tiny. They'll work well there. Ah! Dropped one over there. They're flying everywhere. Okay. Let's put two little dollops. Oh, come on. There we go. One there. There. Anyways, so what's new with you guys? Anybody crafting? Do anything fun? And it's weird just sitting here talking to myself. But it's okay. I'm kind of used to it. Not where I want it. That's good enough. Alrighty, so this is it for the card. If you guys have any questions, let me know. I will link, I will list the products that I use in the description box below. There are several different places where you can get the Sue Wilson dies. I myself bought these from Create and Craft. They no longer carry the Sue Wilson because I used to get it from there because they used to put these on sale. When I bought these were what? I bought them 40% off, which is a good deal because these are expensive and these are extremely hard to get anywhere else. Alrighty, so there is my completed card. I will go ahead and take pictures and put them in at the end of the video so you guys can take a close-up look at the card. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.